Today I am in the last part of the lesson called arithmetic progression. I am feeling very happy today. Why? Because I completed this particular chapter. What is the name of the chapter? Arithmetic progression. And I am in the exercise 1.3. The last two problems left in this particular chapter. See children, in this lesson what all I completed in the previous classes. So many classes I took. The first one is the definition of arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is nothing but the list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to its preceding term except for the first term. First term of the arithmetic progression is called A and the common difference is D. The general formula is A comma A plus D comma A plus 2D comma dash dash dash. We dealt with four different formulas. One is An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Sn is equal to N into N plus 1 divided by 2. That is for the natural numbers. And Sn is equal to N by 2 into A plus L when the last term is given. Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. In addition to this particular the four formulas, there is one more formula we derived, that is An is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. And we solve all the problems given in the textbook, and you have to practice. Once the chapter is over, it is your duty, work it again. Again solve all the problems. How many times you solve, that much expertization you become. You become an expert in solving the problems of arithmetic progression. Therefore, what you have to do is, after completion of this chapter, once again, revise the whole lesson. Right? See here. The last problem, last part of the problem, it is 19th problem of exercise 1.3. 200 logs are stacked in the following manner. 200 logs means wooden logs. Wooden logs are stacked in the following manner. 200 logs are there. How they stack? They stack. They are how they arranged. Okay. How they arranged? 20 logs in the bottom row. First row, they kept 20. Above that, 19. The next row, second row is 19. First is 20. Next is 19. Next is 18. Like that, they go on adding. Kept. How many, what is the total number of logs? 200 logs. Well, how many logs in the first row? 20. Next one is 19. Next one is 18. Next one is 17. How many rows are there? That we have to calculate. And how many rows are there in the 200 logs placed? And how many logs are there in the top row? Top row, how many are there? That you have to calculate. Just like they are given a diagram. See, logs means wooden logs. Like this, 20 logs they kept in the first row. Above that, like this. Wood, they kept like this. This is first row, second row, third row, like that. Go on keeping. Total number of logs is 200. How many logs are there in the top row? How many rows are there? There are two questions. How many rows are there? And what is the number of logs present in the last row? Therefore, the list of number is very simple. See, the list of numbers, I write like this. First is 20, the next is 19, next is 18, like this. 20, 19, 18, 17, like this. Now what he is telling is, sum is equal to, what is the total number of logs in that complete stack? It is 200. Sum is equal to 200. Now see, sum is equal to 200. A is equal to 20. The first number is 20. D is decreasing 1 by 1. Therefore, D is equal to minus 1. D is equal to minus 1. We have to find N. How many such rows are there? That we have to calculate. They are given the sum. They are given the first term. They are given the common difference.
we are to find only the number of rows of logs are required to accommodate 200 logs of wood. Very simple it is. A is there, B is there, N we have to calculate, Sn is given. The formula is Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 of D. Sn is equal to what? Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Sn, how many? What is the total number of wooden blocks present there? Some 200, which is equal to M, we have to calculate, that is N by 2. 2A, 2 into A is 20, plus number of blocks, number of rows of blocks, we don't know that. Therefore, that is N, N as N only, D is equal to minus 1. D is equal to minus 1. 200 is equal to N by 2 into 2 into 20 is 40. Plus, now I have to multiply, I have to open this particular bracket. Minus 1 into N is minus 1. Minus is there, therefore I should change the sign. Plus into minus is minus, while N into 1 is N, minus N. Then, minus into minus is plus, plus 1. Can I able to understand, isn't it? Minus 1 into N, minus N. This is plus. Minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1. Now, like terms, see, now the problem is, if I add the like terms, 200 equals N by 2 into 40 plus 1 is 41 minus N. See here, to eliminate this 2, we have two options. One is by taking the common factor, then we can cancel this. But unfortunately, we don't have any common factor here. Therefore, by taking common factor, we can't eliminate. Then we have another option, that is cross multiplication. Cross multiplication, we can do it. 200 into 2. 200 into 2 is 400. 200 into 2 is what? 400. Then it becomes N of 41 minus N. This 2 is multiplied with 200, it becomes 400. 2 is gone here. And N into 41 minus. See, this is simple. One is taking common factor and eliminating or multiplying. Now we used the method of multiplication. Instead of division, we took a method of multiplication. 200 into 2 is 400. Now, next step, I have to remove this bracket. What happens? 400 is equal to N into 41. 41 N. N into minus N. Minus N square. See here. We reach the quadratic equation. 400 is equal to 41 N minus N square. Here, N square is the variable having highest power. It is negative in nature. Therefore, we should make it as positive. Therefore, I transfer this part to this cell. Then sign changes. Minus N square becomes plus N square. Plus 41 N becomes minus 41 N. This 400 is there only. Plus 400 is equal to 0. Now, factorization we have to do. Is that, again I tell you, this is you studied in 8th standard, splitting the middle term and factorizing. How to split middle term? Because this number is, we have to multiply 400 into N, 400 N square. Now we have to identify the factors of, see, this is our thinking factor. You have to get a number, two numbers. By multiplying them, you should get 400. By multiplying them, you should get 400. By adding them, you should get 41. How to find?
you have to guess two numbers. By multiplying those two numbers, you have to get 400. By adding those two numbers, you have to get 41. That is the thing you have to think. Some many children, what happened with the factorization? They don't think at all. Get two numbers. Adding those two numbers, you have to get 41. Multiplying those two numbers, you should get 400. Which are the numbers? How to get? For that one, there is a trick. The trick is called prime factorization. What I do is, 400 I take, this is a number I take, I divide by prime numbers. The first prime number is 2. I go on divide by 2. 200s are 2. 100s are 2. 50s are 2. 25s, right? Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Still, 5 I can do it. I know that number, which is that number. See, using these numbers, now I should make a tape. What I do is, I multiply this 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 2s are 16. 16 into 25. 16 into 25 is 400, right? 16 into 25 is 400. 16 plus 25 is 41. 16 into 25, 16 plus 25 is 41. 16 into 25 is 400. Therefore, I got the two numbers. The numbers are 16, one, another one is 25. By adding 16 and 25, I get 41. 16 into 25 is 400. This is the correct number. What is the sign here? Plus. This is minus. Therefore, I have to add 16 and 25. Therefore, minus 16, minus 25. Minus 16, minus 25 is equal to minus 41. Variable is n. If you multiply minus into minus, plus. 16 into 25, 400. N into n, n square. I got the number. Now I subtract, split the middle term. Minus 41 is splitted into minus 16n and minus 25. Therefore, the next step is n square minus 16n minus 25n plus 400 is equal to 0. The speciality of this number 16 and 25 is by adding them you get 41, by multiplying them you get 400. That is the trick of getting the number. Now, grouping the first two and the last two. N square and n, I can take n as a common factor. Then it becomes n minus 16. Minus is there. Between 25 and 400, I can easily take 25 as a common factor. Just how I did, 25 into 16 is 400. Therefore, 25, n, here I should get plus, therefore it should be minus. Minus into minus, plus. 16 is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. Therefore, n minus 16, both places n minus 16 is there as a common factor. N minus 25 is equal to 0. N minus 16, n minus 25 is equal to 0. N minus 16, n minus 25 is equal to 0 means out of these two, one thing is equal to 0. Therefore, n minus 16 is equal to 0 or n minus 25 is equal to 0. Between these two, one number is equal to 0. N minus 16 is equal to 0 or n minus 25 is equal to 0. Now n minus 16 is equal to 0 means n is equal to 16 or n is equal to 25. N is equal to 16 or n is equal to 25. See, this is a very fantastic problem it is. Why? Because according to our knowledge, n should be a natural number. Usually we get two numbers. One is natural number, another one is not natural number, therefore we select the one. Here what happened? Both are natural numbers only. 16 is a natural number. And 25 is a natural number. Positive integer it is. Therefore I can tell that n may be 16 or 25. The number of logs, now how many rows or logs are there? It may be 16 or it may be 25. Again you have to cross check it. Is it possible to do like this or we have to cross check it? Therefore, what happened? Now, number of
number of rows of locks may be 16 or 25. It may be 16 or 25. Now how to cross check this? That we have to think. It may be 16 or 25. It may be we can make 16 rows of locks or 25 rows of locks also we can keep. That is the thing. Therefore, we have to decide on which one to select. How to select? That we go further. Before that, first we understand this problem. See, wooden locks are arranged how many? 200 in such a manner. First row 20, next is 19, next is 18. Sum is 200. Total number is 200. First row is 20. Common difference is minus 1. N is equal to first row. Oh. Yeah, sum is there, A is there, D is there, N to be calculated. I use the formula Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2N plus N minus 1 into D. Substituted and I got the answer. The final answer, I got two answers. Now we have to cross check it. Out of two answers, which one is right? First you have to write up to it because I want to go, I have to erase this. First what you have to do, we got two answers. Which are the two answers? The number of rows may be 16 or number of rows may be 25. That we have to cross check it. We can easily cross check it because one more question is there. How many logs are there in the upper row? Upper row, how many are there? That we have to calculate. That we calculate. At that time we understand which one is right, which one is wrong. But according to the mathematical approach, both the numbers are natural numbers. Therefore, n may be 16 or 25. It may be 16 or 25. We have two options. The number of rows may be 16 or number of rows may be 25. Now what I do is, if number of rows is equal to 16, if number of rows is equal to 16, what happens? A is equal to 20 as it is, first row is 20 and D is minus 1. D is minus 1 and N is equal to 16. Now I am taking number of rows as 16, but I don't know the value of AN. How many logs are there in this particular row? That is the last row. Which is the row? 16th row. First row 20, next row 19. Like that, 16th rows are there. And first one is 20, the common difference is minus 1, number of rows is 16. I don't know what is the value of AN. AN means A16. I don't know. Take calculate. What is the formula? AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 of D. This is the formula. Now what I do is, in the place of N I write 16. A16 is equal to 20 plus 16 minus 1, n is equal to 16, we assume that n is equal to 16, d is equal to minus 1. Therefore, A16 is equal to, what happened, 20 plus 15 into minus 1, 15 into minus 1, A16 is equal to 20 minus 15, 20 minus 15 is 5. Therefore, number of logs in the 16th row, the topmost row, is 5. Correct. Understood? If you consider number of rows is equal to 16, the topmost row, that is 16th row, there are 5 logs. Now we consider the second option. This is the second option. If number of rows is equal to 25, because we got two answers there, 16 and 25. Suppose the number of rows is equal to 25, then what happened? A is equal to, as it as usual, 20. D is equal to minus 1. N is equal to, we assume that it is 25. We don't know the value of AN. AN value we don't know. Suppose the number of rows is equal to 25, AN we don't know. Formula, usual, AN is equal to A plus n minus 1 into v. A25, if it is there, 25th row is there, in that row how many wooden blocks should be there? A25, A is equal to 20, n is equal to 25 minus 1, d is equal to minus 1. A25 is equal to 20 plus 24 into minus 1. 25 minus 1 is 24. 24 into minus 1. A25 is equal to 20 minus 24. 20 minus 24 is equal to minus 4. See this. Can you imagine a row is having minus 4 logs? Impossible. This is wrong. The number of logs in a row cannot be negative. It should be always positive. Therefore, we assume that the number of rows are not equal to 25. No doubt we got the answer as 16 and 25. The number of rows in that particular system is 16. If it is 16 rows, we get the number of logs in the topmost row is 5. Suppose if you consider 25, the number of logs in the last row becomes minus 4. How it can possible? When you wanted to count anything, it should be positive. Minus 4 logs, wrong it is. Therefore, how many rows are there? 60. How many wooden logs are there in the 16th row? 5. That is the answer. Right? Once again, I repeat, some people may get confused in this. See, this is a very nice problem. Because when we reach the last stage of the problem, the problems are little, they make it complicated. Why? Because the children has to think long. See, what is this? Wooden logs are there. How many are there? 200. You have to stack them. You have to arrange them. How you arrange? First row 20, above 90, above 80, like that, long keeping. The log, once it 200 logs are over, you stop. By that, what you have to understand, how many rows are there? To identify number of rows, I use this method. List is like this. Sum is 200. Sum SN is equal to, I did. Finally, I got number of rows, maybe 16 or 25. It may be 16 or 25. Now, we got two answers. Two are also positive numbers. When we got two answers, we get a doubt. To solve that doubt, we do the next step. If the number of rows are 16, how many logs are there in the 16th row? That I calculated. I got it as 5. 5 is a positive number, it is possible. Here what happens, if I consider number of rows is equal to 25, then the number of logs in the 25th row is minus 4. It is impossible. Therefore, now the conclusion, there is no place to write the answer. The conclusion is, how many rows are there? 16 rows. Therefore, you have to write now. After writing this, you have to write now. What do you have to write? In this, there are 16 rows. There are 16 rows are there, and in the 16th row contains 5 logs. You have to write like that. That is the beauty of this particular problem. Last problem of the exercise 1.3, 20th problem. See, this problem, I think everybody can be able to solve. Why? Because if you any time participated in the sports, there you are influenced or you understood how that game is run, how that sport is going. Using that knowledge, you can easily solve this problem. See, the problem is like this. In a school, there is a sports competition. There is a potato race. We all know that, alu gadde race, potato race. Very simple, nice it is. Easy for small children in kindergarten or in primary schools, they usually do this potato race. How you play? If you understand that one, you can easily solve the problem. What is that? In a potato race, a bucket is placed at a starting point which is 5 meters from the first potato. I write the diagram. I have given the diagram in the textbook. You can understand easily it is. Very easy it is. See, here there is a bucket. Imagine here there is a bucket. In front of the bucket, there is a straight line is drawn. In a potato race, a bucket is placed at the starting point. Starting point is a bucket. And which is if a potato is kept, the first potato is kept from 5 meters from the bucket. 5 meters. This is one potato. Okay, I write potato. One potato. 5 meters. The next potato is kept at a distance of 3 meters, not 5. 3 meters here. Second one, second potato is at a distance of 3 meters from the first one. Next one is at a distance of 3 meters again. The remaining all they kept at a distance of 3 meters. Like this. First one is at a distance of 5 meters from the bucket. The next one is 3. Total there are 10 potatoes are kept in the bucket. Understand? Very simple it is. Bucket is there. From the bucket 5 meter distance, one potato. The same line after 3 meters from the first potato, another potato. From 3 meters from the second potato, another potato. 10 potatoes are kept. How many? 10. Total 10. Now the question is, there are 10. How to play this? There is no need to explain this. You know how to play this. How to play? You have to stand near the bucket. You have to run. Pick the potato. And you have to run back. Therefore, what is the total distance covered by you to pick one potato, first one? How many? Because it is kept at a distance of 5 meters. You have to run 5 meters forward. After picking that, you have to run 5 meters backward. So 5 plus 5 is what? 10. Therefore, first potato is picked by covering 10 meters of distance. What about the second one? The second one is, you have to run from here, bucket, to this distance. This is 5 plus 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 is not sufficient. After picking that, what you have to do? You have to come back. You have to come back 8. Like that, you have to run to pick 10 potatoes. Therefore, what he is asking is, what is the total distance covered by the competitor? You have to calculate total distance covered by the competitor. Very simple problem, see. I write it here, see. The list of numbers. Always you have to take the list of numbers. Easy it is. List of numbers I take. First potato is at a distance of 5 meters, right? Second one is at a distance of 3 meters from the first potato. Therefore, it becomes you have to add 5 plus 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. 5 plus 3 is what? 8. And the third potato is kept at a distance of 3 meters from the second potato. Therefore, add 3 to this, it becomes 11. Next one is 14. Like that, how many? 10 terms. How many terms are there? Here I write terms, actually it is potatoes. 10 potatoes are placed in such a manner. First potato is kept at a distance of 5 meters. The next one is 3. Therefore, add 3 to 5, it becomes 88. Add 3 to 8, it becomes 11. Add 3 to 11, it becomes 14, like this. This is a distance kept. But the fellow, or a competitor, he has to cover what? Twice. Once you have to forward, you have to move. Like this, you have to go. Then you have to run back. Therefore, the distance is multiplied by 2. Therefore, the series becomes 2 of 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus 14 plus that. How many terms? 10 terms. Now you have to understand this. Why I return to once, one time I wanted to go forward. The next time I wanted to come back. Therefore, I should, each distance is multiplied by 2. Therefore, I take it 2. This is the distance of the placement of potato in the straight line, right?
Now what the next is? You have to multiply. Be careful. Don't multiply this.
20 terms are not there.
Then only. You multiply each term. These are called the terms. Then it becomes what? It becomes 10. This becomes 16. This becomes 22. This becomes 28.
Like that, how many potatoes are there? Potato cannot be double.
Potato is 10 only. Understand? Don't multiply this number. This number tells that how many potatoes are kept.
How many? 10 only. To pick each potato, you have to run twice. Understood? To pick one potato, you have to run twice. How many potato? 10.
What is the placement of the potato? 5, 8, 11, 11. Now,
the problem is over.
First term. See the first term. First term is 10. D. Common difference. A2 minus A1, which is equal to 16 minus 10, which is equal to 6. How many potatoes are got? N is equal to 10. What do you have to find? Yes, 10. You have to find the distance you have to carry. Sum, total. You have to carry. Simple problem. Formula is A, D, N is known to us. Therefore, the formula is SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. N minus 1 into D. Yes. How many potatoes? 10 potatoes. M is equal to 10. 10 by 2. 2 into A. A is the first term. 10 it is. Plus N is also 10. 10 minus 1. 10 potatoes. N. D. D is equal to 6. D is equal to 6. Therefore, S10 is equal to 10 divided by 2. You know, 10, if you divide it by 2, you get 5. 2 into 10. 2 into 10, 20. Plus 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 into 6. 9 into 6. Then, S10. The total distance, that's the commutator has to run, is equal to 5 of 20 plus 9 6 are 54. 9 6 are what? 54. S 10 is equal to 5. 20 plus 54. 20 plus 54 is 74. Now S 10 is equal to 5 4s are 20. 5 4s are 22. 5 7s are 35. 5 7s are 5 4s are 22. 5 7s are how much it is? 5 7s are 35 plus 2, 37. 37. This is the distance. 370 is the distance covered by the competitor to complete all the, to pick 10 potatoes. Very simple, I repeat once again. The question is very simple. Potatoes are placed. First is 5 meter from the potato. The next is 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. The competitor has to run forward and pick the potato and come back. Therefore, the distances are 5, 8, 11, 14, so on up to 10 potatoes. Since he has to come back, we have to multiply by 2. Therefore, the terms becomes 10, 16, 22, so on up to 10 terms. A is equal to 10, B is equal to 6, and N is equal to 10, S10 is equal to question mark. Formula, S10 is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. This is the formula. Then what you have to do? You have to substitute 10 by 2, 2 into 10. What is this 10? 10 is the first term. 10 minus 1 into 6, 10 minus 1 is 9 into 6. 20 plus 9 into 6, 29 into 6 is 54, 74 into 5, 370. Therefore, the total distance covered
covered is equal to 370 meters.
See children, I completed this particular chapter. What is the name of the chapter? Arithmetic progression. In this chapter, in the public examination, we can think of 8 marks. There are more than 60 problems are there. More than 60 problems are there. All problems are solved. All problems are based on 4 main formulas and 1 skill part. Totally 5 formulas. And all the 5 formulas you have to write in the formula book. Formulas are AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. SN is equal to N into N plus 1 divided by 2. SN is equal to N by 2 into A plus L. And SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 of D. And the last one in the skill part is AN is equal to SN minus SN minus 1. This many formulas we used and we solve all the problems. All the problems are solved in the videos. And I given all the problems, substitute problems. Means the same type of problem with different numbers also I given. Therefore, write once in the class workbook that is completed. Notes also make it proper. Right? Now, see the one question. What is that? What type of question we can guess in the public examination? Recently means 19th maths, this year maths students have written maths examination, and the maths exam, this is a maths examination paper, and this paper is in multiple choice. When you see this question paper, completely multiple choice. You don't get multiple choice completely. In our examination, in your examination, you get 8 marks. Before concluding this particular chapter, it is better, which are the questions came for this year, like this paper? What type of multiple choice questions came for this paper that we want to solve? After solving, we tell that our portion is over, because the revision, public examination paper, everything is over. The next part is yours. You have to practice. You have to practice. Then you get how many marks? 8 marks in the public examination. 8 marks means what? 10% of your maths scoring. 10%. Therefore, don't be neglect. What you have to do is practice. Now I solve this problem, because since it is a multiple choice, I put it in a slide and show to you, because options are there. A question and options are there. We solve that, and that ends the chapter called arithmetic progression. In the next class, I start mathematics. Physics part. I go for electricity. I start with the electricity chapter. Right? Hello children. The recently concluded mathematics, science, and social studies paper on 19th of this month. It is completely based on multiple choice. We select the problems of arithmetic progression solve. And this type of question paper you are not going to get. You are going to get the writing type of question papers. Therefore, but it is for the practice. Okay, we start. The first question means the question in the tech question paper is, nth term of an arithmetic progression is an is equal to 4n plus 5. Then its fifth term is, nth term is given, an is equal to 4n plus 5. And its fifth term is, 4 options he is given. A is 20, B is 14, C is 25, D is 24. If you are good in solving problems, you can directly write. But how to solve this? See what is given. An is equal to 4n plus 5 is given. What you have to find? You have to find the fifth term. Therefore, put n is equal to 5. In the place of n, replace 5. What happens? It becomes A5 is equal to 4 of 5 plus 5. Then you go for simplification. A5 is equal to 4 into 5 is 20, 20 plus 5, and A5 is equal to 25. Therefore, the answer for this particular question is 25. In which option we can find 25? See, C is 25. Therefore, the correct answer for the question given in the multiple choice question paper is C, that is 25. How simple questions there. Very simple. This type of questions only you get, but you have to solve those questions, because you don't get multiple choice question papers. Next question. Which of the following is an arithmetic progression?
See, he is given four options. A, 1, comma, minus 1, comma, minus 2. B is 159. C is 2, minus 2, 2, minus 2, like that. D is equal to 1, 2, 4, 8. Among the four options given, one is arithmetic progression. You have to identify the arithmetic progression. Is in arithmetic progression, there is a common difference. What is arithmetic progression? Arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to its preceding term, right? Except for the first term. Now I work it out. The first option A is given. I work it out. A is given as 1 minus 1 minus 2. Therefore, D is equal to, we have to find D to identify it is an arithmetic progression or not. D is equal to A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1 is equal to minus 1 minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 become D. A3 minus A2 I find. There I get minus 1 because it is minus 2 minus of minus 1, which is equal to minus 1. We know that minus 2 is not equal to minus 1. Therefore, the first option is not an AP. Second one, 159 is given. First I find A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1 I get it as 4. 5 minus 1 is 4. Then I find A3 minus A2. A3 minus A2 is 9 minus 5. 9 minus 5 is also 4. 4 is equal to 4. I know that it is an AP. Now it is enough. B is the correct answer for this particular question. Since I am solving the paper, I solve the other two also. In the part of C, what happens? C 2 minus 2, 2 minus 2. There A2 minus A1 is equal to minus 4 and A3 minus A2 is equal to 4. We know that minus 4 is not equal to 4. Therefore, it is not an AP. In the fourth option, 1, 2, 4, 8. A2 minus A1, we get it as 1 and A3 minus A2 as 2. We know that 1 is not equal to 2. Therefore, it is not AP. Therefore, the second option, B, is the right answer. That is, 159 is an AP. The right answer is B for this particular question. But why I am solving this particular question paper is, see, this is the standard of the public examination paper. Once you understand how easily you can score marks in the public examination, therefore, what is your duty now? You have to practice all the problems given in the textbook and get ready for the public examination. The next question is, the 11th term of an AP, 11th term of an AP, minus 3, minus 1, 1, 3 is, 4 options given. A is equal to 23, B is equal to minus 23, C is equal to minus 17, D is equal to 17. How to find the 11th term of an AP? There is A is equal to minus 3. D is equal to A2 minus A1. Since he is given arithmetic progress, there is no need to find the other things. Only find A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1 is equal to minus 1 minus of minus 3. Minus 1 plus 3. D is equal to 2. D is equal to 2. N is equal to 11. We have to find the 11th term. Therefore, N is equal to 11. The formula is, the first formula, that is, An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. That is the formula used to find the terms of the arithmetic progression. Then substitute the values. A11 is equal to minus 3 plus N is equal to 11 minus 1, D is equal to 2. Therefore, A11 is equal to minus 3 plus 11 minus 1 of 2. First, you have to solve the bracket part. That is, 11 minus 1 is, it becomes 10. Then multiply 10 and 2. You get A11 is equal to minus 3 plus 20. Minus 3 plus signs are different, therefore you have to subtract and put the sign of the bigger number. Therefore, A11 is equal to 17. 17 is the right answer for this particular question. Which option is having 17? D is having 17. Therefore, the correct answer is D. That is, the answer is 17. See, if you solve this paper, you can understand. Scoring marks in public examination is very easy, but only one thing is, you have to practice properly. That's all. The next question, sum of the first 10 terms of an AP, arithmetic progression, is 155, and sum of the first 9 terms of the same progression is 126. Then the 10th term of the progression, see, they are given a relationship between sum and the term. We have to find the 10th term. We have to find A10. E is given S10 and S9. See, this is a skill part of the area of arithmetic progression, that is AN is equal to SN minus SN minus 1. We solve this type of problems. AN is equal to SN minus SN minus 1. Therefore, A10 is equal to S10 minus S9. A10 is equal to what? S10 minus S9. This type of problem we solve. It is there in the exercise. Right? A10 is equal to S10 minus S9. Substitute the values. A10 is equal to S10 is given as 155, S9 as 126. Therefore, A10 is equal to 155 minus 126. 155 minus 126 is 29. A10 is equal to 29. Therefore, the right answer for this particular question is 29. Which option we can find 29C? Therefore, the right answer is 29. This is a very, see, I already told you, while teaching this particular content, I told you, this type of question gives for the multiple choice. Very easy to answer this. Any term if you want to find, you have to find the relationship between term and the sum. The relation is AN is equal to SN minus SN minus 1. That is the relation you have to always keep in mind. This is the question. The next question. If 4, x, 10 are in arithmetic progression, find the value of x is. Value of x you have to find. See, he is given the first term, that is 4. He is given the third term, that is 10. We have to find the second term. First term is given, third term is given. We have to find the second term. A3 is equal to 10, A is equal to 4. But A3, we know that A3 is equal to 2 plus A plus 2D. A plus 2D is equal to A3. Substitute those values. A3, in the place of A3, you can write 10. In the place of A, you write 4. 4 plus 2D. Simplification, 10 minus 4 is equal to 2D. 6 is equal to 2D. Therefore, D is equal to 3. Then you know the value of common difference. Add that common difference to the first term, you get the second term. First term is what? 4. Therefore, the second term is, he is given as x. X is equal to 4 plus D. D already calculated by us as 3. Therefore, x is equal to 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 is the answer for this particular multiple choice question. See, children, this is the content called arithmetic mean. Since this particular content is not given in the textbook, I have not used that technique of finding the middle term of arithmetic progression. It is called the arithmetic mean. This can be solved by another trick called arithmetic mean, where the definition is like this. If A, B, C, if three terms are in A, B, C, three terms A, B, C are in AP, then the middle term, which is the middle term B, B is equal to A plus C by 2, means middle term is equal to first term plus third term divided by 2. It is called the mean, arithmetic mean. B is equal to A plus C by 2. Therefore, we can directly find the value of x as x is equal to 4 plus 10 by 2. 4 is the first term, 10 is the third term. To find the second term, 4 plus 10 divided by 2, that is 14 by 2 is equal to 7. But this type of content or this type of problem is not given in the textbook. It was in the old syllabus. It is not in the new syllabus. Therefore, I have not used this particular content. I solve by using the content what is given in the textbook. Any problem can be solved by any number of methods. But this is also one of the method in the your textbook. The last line that is given in a colored box. That's why I am telling this. It is a concept called arithmetic mean, right? Any method you can adopt, but it is better to adopt the method given in the textbook. That is always good for scoring marks. See, I solve all the problems given in the recently concluded public examination. Okay, now you practice arithmetic progression problems once again in a separate book and be prepared for your examination. Right, always see this particular chapter fetches you 8 marks. 8 marks means 10%.